Good morning all. Myself Dr. Apeksha Dhole, Professor Oral Medicine and Radiology. And today I'll be dealing with the topic Maxillary Occlusal Radiography. Now students, when I say Maxillary Occlusal Radiography, we all know intraoral radiography, it consists of intraoral periapical radiograph, bite-wing radiograph, and third is the occlusal radiograph. In earlier, earlier videos, I have discussed the intraoral radiography, and today I'll be discussing the maxillary occlusal radiograph. Now, occlusal radiography, also known as sandwich radiography, it is used to examine large areas of upper and the lower jaw. This is a supplementary radiographic technique that is usually used in conjunction with the periapical or the bite-wing radiograph. The palate and the floor of mouth may be examined. Now, this is an occlusal radiographic film. Now, what are the indications for maxillary occlusal radiograph? Is first to locate the retained roots of extracted tooth, to locate supernumerary, unerupted or impacted teeth, to locate foreign bodies in maxilla or mandible. Now, you can see this is a maxillary one, the impacted tooth and the foreign bodies if they are located in the maxillary region. To locate and evaluate the extent of lesion, that is cysts, tumors or malignancies in maxilla and mandible, it is specially indicated to determine the mesial and lateral extent of the lesion and its extent in the palate. To evaluate the boundaries of maxillary sinus, that is anterior, mesial and the lateral. Can you see this is an outline of the lesion which cannot be seen in the periapical radiograph if you want. The mesial and the lateral extension can be seen in the occlusal radiograph. Then to evaluate fracture of maxilla and mandible, that is location, extent and its displacement, to aid in the examination of patients who cannot open their mouth more than few millimeters, or in adults and children who are unable to tolerate the periapical films. Then to examine area of cleft palate, to measure the changes in size and shape of maxilla and mandible. Now this radiographic occlusal radiograph is showing the cleft palate, clefts in the palate. Now, what are the basic principle? Can you see this is a radio? This is a film I have shown already. Now, this is a surface where the occlusion, the convexity or the embossed dot is present. And this is a backside. Now, film is positioned with this white side facing the arch that is being exposed. That is, if I want the maxillary arch occlusal radiograph, this white side should face towards the maxillary occlusal surface. Then film is placed in a mouth between the occlusal surfaces of maxillary and the mandibular tooth, and so the name is the occlusal radiograph. Then film is stabilized when the patient gently bite on the surface. Again, patient don't have to press it on, just gently biting, gentle holding of the film rather than I say, so that there should not be any points on the tooth on the film. Then for maxillary occlusal film, the patient's head must be positioned so that the upper arch is parallel to the floor and the mid-sagittal plane is perpendicular to the floor. This is the position of a patient when maxillary occlusal radiography is planned. The different views are cross-sectional radiograph, then topography, anterior and the lateral view. Now how the cross-sectional maxillary view is made? The image field, this projection, you can see palate, zygomatic process of maxilla, antero-inferior aspect of each antrum, then nasolacrimal canal, teeth from second molar to the second molar and nasal septum. How the film is placed? Sit the patient in an upright position with the sagittal plane perpendicular to the floor and occlusal plane is horizontal. Place the receptor. Now here receptor is the film with its long dimension perpendicular to the sagittal plane, long dimension perpendicular to the sagittal plane, crosswise in the mouth. Gently push the receptor in backward until it contacts the anterior border of mandibular rama. The film has to be pushed in such a way that it will be placed at the maximum to the mandibular rama. Patient stabilizes the receptor by gently closing the mouth. Then how, this is a diagrammatic representation. This is a film which has been placed and now the projection of the X-ray film. Direct the central ray at the vertical angulation of plus 65 degree and a horizontal angulation of 0 degree to the bridge of nose. Now this is a bridge of nose that is just below the nasion towards the middle of the receptor. Now this is a film. This is the middle part, approximately middle, and through the bridge of nose you are making an angulation of plus 65 vertical angulation and 0 degree horizontal angulation. The point of entry, central ray enters the patient's face through the bridge of nose. Here we can say this is an anatomical location, bridge of nose. Then the second is maxillary topographic view, that is anterior topography. Now can you see there is a difference between the cross section and anterior topography? Now image field here is the anterior maxilla and its dentition, anterior floor of the nasal fossa, and the teeth from canine to canine. You can see teeth from canine to canine with all its root. Can you see all its root? Can be seen very well in the maxillary topographic image. Then receptor placement. Again, the placement will be adjust the patient's head so that the sagittal plane is perpendicular to the occlusal plane in a horizontal, is horizontal to the floor. Place the receptor in the mouth with the exposure site towards the maxilla and posterior border touching the rami, and the long dimension of the receptor perpendicular to the sagittal plane. Patient stabilizes the receptor by gently closing mouth or using gentle bilateral thumb pressure. Ask the patient to just make the film in such a way that it will be placed. It will be placed in such a way that all the anterior teeth will be covered. Now projection. Again, this is a diagrammatic representation. Here also you can see this occlusal film placed in such a way that it is in between the maxillary and the mandibular occlusal surfaces. Orient the central ray through the tip of nose here, from the tip of nose to the middle of the receptor with approximately of plus 45 degree vertical angulation and 0 degree horizontal angulation. Here you can see very well the central ray of is directing from patient's face, that is tip of nose, at an angulation of plus 45. The third is maxillary lateral topography. Now that was anterior, where you can see the canine to canine, and here we can see the lateral aspect, that is a quadrant of the alveolar ridge of maxilla, then inferolateral aspect of the antrum, the tuberosity, you can see the tuberosity, teeth from the lateral incisor, teeth from lateral incisor to the contralateral third molar, it can be seen. In addition, the zygomatic process of maxilla superimposes over the root of molar tip. Now this is for lateral. Again, the name itself suggests it's of a lateral side, anterior side, and the cross-sectional side. Now how the film will be placed in the lateral aspect? Place the film receptor, its long axis parallel to the sagittal plane, similar way, on the side of interest with the tube side towards the side of the maxilla in question. Now tube should be placed on a side which on the lateral side you want. If it is on the lateral side, place the tubes on the lateral side. Push the receptor posteriorly until it touches the ramus. Now, this here is some difference. Position the lateral border parallel with the buccal surface of the posterior teeth, extending laterally approximately 1 centimeter past the buccal cusp. Now, this is the arrangement because we want to cover the lateral aspect of the teeth. Then ask patient to close gently to hold the receptor in position. Now, this is again a diagrammatic representation where orient the. Now, this is the representation is of a left side. Here, the patient's face is on the right side. This is for right side when I want, and this is the representation is for left side if I want the occlusal radiography. That is lateral ray topography. Orient the central ray with the vertical angulation plus 60 to the point 2 centimeter below the lateral canthus of eye. Now, lateral canthus of eye, 2 centimeter below, you are going to point directed toward the center of the receptor. Now the central ray here, we can say 2 centimeter below it approximately, and it is directing to the center of the film. Now here to conclude, before to conclude, we will just summarize in few seconds. That is, there are three views. One is cross-sectional, another is anterior topographic, third is the lateral topographic. Cross-sectional, I can see from molar to molar, anteriorly canine to canine, and lateral, when I say from lateral incisor of one side to the molar of another side. for cross sectional angulation from bridge of nose plus 65, for anterior topography it is from the tip of nose plus 45, and from for the latter it should be 2 cm below the lateral canthus of eye, and it should be plus 60 degree angulation. Okay, everywhere the horizontal angulation should be 0 degree. Okay, now to conclude, occlusal radiography in conjunction with the periapical or bitwing radiography help to localize the objects in the oral cavity and jaws. Now students, for final year, it is you are not being asked in the examination to take the radiograph. That is only IOP radiograph. But the question may be asked for indications, any technique, and most of the time in practical, the viva questions are asked, and to interpret, to write, and how the radiograph is to be made. Now with this, I think it is very clear to you that how the radiograph, occlusal radiograph, maxillary occlusal radiograph is made, what are different indications. So if you are having any queries, you can ask to me to, with this, I think these are my references. Thank you.